Hi! Tonic water is fluorescent due to its quinine content. Shine ultraviolet light on it and it glows in a beautiful soft blue color. In my previous video, I showed that the color of this luminescent glow is independent of the excitation light. But for other factors, we did see indications of changes in the intensity of the glow. In this video, I'll dig deeper into some ways of changing the intensity. And I'll reveal if any of you guessed what I poured into the tonic water. Something that turns off the fluorescence of quinine completely. Avoid exposure to high intensity ultraviolet light. Do not heat normal glass on a hot plate and do not place hot lamps near something flammable. Let's start with testing the effects of a temperature change. In my last video, it looks like the glow is stronger when the tonic water is colder. Time to measure if there is a difference. I will use my strongest UVA light for this, a 400 watts monster that takes some time to warm up. I will give it 15 minutes to thermally stabilize its output. Doesn't look like much, but remember, the ultraviolet is invisible to us. For measuring the intensity of the fluorescence, I will use a lux meter, protected by a brick, to keep it from melting in the lamp's scorching heat. The experiment will be to compare tonic water at two temperatures, at room temperature and fridge cold, using double-walled insulated glass to avoid condensation issues. After just 1 minute, I think you can see the difference. There is no condensation on the thermoglass. The first test glass is filled with demineralized water. With no fluorescence, this gives me a reading of the ambient light hitting the lux meter. Unfortunately, the meter's display is slightly fluorescent under strong UV, so I have to use a focus flashlight to read it, without hitting the light sensor, of course. Okay, 75 lux without fluorescence. Now, the room temperature tonic water. Oh yes, the invisible UV is turned into visible light. 400 lux. How about the cold tonic water? It is even brighter, around 440 lux. I tried a couple of times more with the camera on a fixed exposure. For some reason, the readings got higher for each set. I may have moved the glass closer to the sensor. Quite a messy test result, but the cold tonic water had the brightest fluorescence in each set. What if I heat the tonic water instead? Will it dim the fluorescence? Starting at 22 degrees C, exactly. Let's turn on the heat and read for every 10 degrees increase. At 92 degrees, I ended the experiment to avoid a rolling boil. Alright, while the difference is smaller than I thought, it is clear that the fluorescence is temperature dependent. The colder, the stronger the fluorescence, simply because hotter molecules are bouncing more off of each other, exchanging the energy of the excited electrons before they can emit their excess energy as fluorescent light. But even at near boiling temperatures, the tonic water is still fluorescing. What will it take to turn it off completely? Find out after an important message. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. I appreciate your help with keeping these videos like this one coming. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link in the description. Thank you. What did I pour into the tonic water to shut off, quench the fluorescence? There were a lot of guesses from you within the first hour of upload alone. Thanks to all who participated, despite the very few clues in the video. One of you quickly noticed that I seem to use a harmless chemical. And you're right, I would wear gloves and use lab glass, not kitchen glass, if it were a hazardous chemical. These gas is sodium hydrogen carbonate, baking soda, known as natron here in Denmark. Let's try it. I am using degassed tonic water this time to avoid the vigorous bubbling. Funny enough, I am now regassing the water since the baking soda forms carbon dioxide bubbles in the acidic tonic water. A small amount did not remove the fluorescence. Maybe adding more will make a difference. There we go. It certainly quenches the quinine. The fluorescence of quinine is not only temperature, but also pH dependent. It fluoresces the strongest in an acidic solution with a pH of around 3.7 or so. By neutralizing the citric acid in the tonic water with enough of the weak-based baking soda, the pH is raised, heavily quenching the fluorescence. Great and recent guest fee, and countless others of you. It's just that I did not add baking soda in the original clip. I used table salt, sodium chloride. Here's a more precise experiment. I will add 100 milligrams of table salt several times to 200 milliliters of tonic water and plot the dimming of the fluorescence. 100 milligram is not much. Will it make any difference at all? Ambient light is around 60 lux. Without any salt, it reads around 220 lux. Now I will dissolve the first 100 milligrams of table salt in it. Takes some time, but whoa, it has a significant impact on the fluorescence. Adding more, 100 milligrams at the time, increases the effect, though with diminishing return. This works in a similar way as the heat quenching. The chloride ions from the salt steal the energy from the excited electrons in the quinine before they can emit their energy as light. Bromide ions are better than chloride, and iodide ions even better yet. My salt is iodized with potassium iodide, but with only 1.3 milligrams of iodine per 100 gram salt, I'd say the chloride ions are the main quencher here. Even though the iodide ions do help along. So, did anyone guess it right? Of course, the combined knowledge of my viewers is nothing short of amazing. First guess of them all, from Hura Forever, was right, and quickly followed by recent and accurate guesses from Numian Tuft and Michael. A sincere thank you once again to everyone who participated. A comment is so much more relatable than just another anonymous view. I'm glad there's no salt in tonic water to mess up the fluorescence. For comparison, here's another carbonated soft drink that contains quinine. I don't think it is available outside Denmark, but you are not missing out on another fluorescent drink. I see no quinine fluorescence from it, partly because it has much less quinine in it than tonic water. But also because it contains salt, quenching the little fluorescence that might have been. Comment if you know of another drink that will fluoresce. I have an example of a drink fluorescing from its vitamin contents in an earlier video. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more. Bye for now.